Today, I'm super excited because you're gonna learn how to create my most favorite music video effect ever, the paper rip transition. So first of all, you have to duplicate the clip that you want to transition to by holding Alt or Option, clicking on the clip and dragging it up to the next video layer to create a copy. Then make sure your playhead is at the very first frame of that specific clip. Then come all the way up to where it says Clip, click that, and go down to where it says Freeze Frame and click that. Now you've successfully created a still image from that specific clip on the very first frame. Now it is time to determine how long you want each part of those paper animations to be. And in my case, I like to stick to roughly around 2 to 4 frames. So I'm gonna use my right arrow key and I'm gonna go forward 1, 2, and 3, and I'm gonna make a cut right there and I'm gonna delete the end. Now this part here is our end animation. That means where the guy is fully masked out with a paper edge. And in order to do that, I'm gonna jump into the fusion page. Just make sure your playhead is over that specific clip. I'm gonna click the fusion icon down here. And the first thing that I'm gonna do is with my media end one selected, I'm gonna add a polygon mask to that. And right now you can see that everything disappears in a viewer. In order to fix that, I'm gonna come into my inspector in top right corner. I'm gonna click invert. And all the way at the bottom where it says right click here for shape animation, I'm gonna turn off the keyframe because we don't want our shape to be animated. And now it is time to mask out the guy or the subject, the object that you want to make this transition on. Now keep in mind, the longer you take for the masking process, the better the end result's gonna be. And once you've made your selection, just select invert once again so you can actually see what you've masked out. Once we've done that, we wanna jump back to the edit page. And with that specific clip, we wanna shift that over until it aligns perfectly on the cut, overlapping on the first video clip, just like I did right here. And once we've done that, we wanna create the middle animation. In order to do that, we wanna duplicate that specific clip by holding Alt or Option and just clicking, dragging it to the left. Now make sure your playhead is over that specific clip. Jump back into the fusion page, select the polygon one tool. Just make sure right click here for shape animation is still turned off. And what we wanna do then is we wanna select a few points from the top and just delete them like so. Now we wanna add a few more points and get a rough shape. Something like that should do the job just fine. Now go back to the edit page, duplicate that specific clip by holding Alt or Option, dragging it to the left just like so. Put your playhead on top of that specific clip and go back into the fusion page. Now select the polygon one tool, select another few points from the top, delete them, and now just once again create a rough shape. Probably just add a few points in there, like so. The only thing that you have to keep in mind is don't go over the initial shape like that you reveal the background. That's like the only thing that you have to keep in mind there. So I'm just gonna do something like that. I'm gonna put in one more here. That is perfect. Now I'm gonna go back to the edit page. And if we play this back, you can see that we've already made a pretty good animation. So the guy is already unfolding, but we're still missing those paper edges. And thankfully, those are built into DaVinci Resolve in the free version and the studio version. We don't need any third-party plugins or programs. And in order to add them, all you have to do is come up to where it says Effects, come down to where it says Effects once again, and search for paper. Now you see the paper edge effect. Just click, drag and drop this onto each of those clips right there, and a third one right there. And now you can see that we've already made some pretty good paper edges around the masked out subject. Now, if you wanna fine tune that, what you can do is select the specific clip, come up to the inspector in the top right corner, go down to where it says effects, and here you can see the paper edge effect. If you watch very closely at the end, it's a little bit laggy. And it's all about the fine details. And that is because this frame right here is the exact copy of the first frame of the next clip. In order to fix that, you can take all three of those clips and move them over by one frame. Or how I like to do it is I'm just gonna trim off the first frame of the second clip and I'm just gonna shift that over. And now if you watch this back, it's a lot more smooth. And it's all about those fine little details that probably no one will ever notice, but that just makes a video really great. So right now it is a lot more smooth. But before we get to the secret sauce to really sell this effect, let's hear a quick word from today's sponsor, MotionVFX. If you're editing music videos or live performances for artists as I do, mMusicVideo 2 by MotionVFX is the perfect plugin for you. It has been created by MotionVFX in collaboration with the well-known YouTuber YC Imaging, who's very popular on YouTube for his music video tutorials. And within this pack are more than 60 creative music video presets specifically designed for DaVinci Resolve. We're talking about film mats, overlay effects, photo slideshows, split screens, transitions, titles, and camera movements. So with this one single pack, you're ready to go to make your music video really stand out. And if you're interested in checking out mMusicVideo 2 and in supporting the channel, click the link in the description to get a full preview of what's included in mMusicVideo 2. Thank you, MotionVFX, for sponsoring this video. But now let's continue with the secret sauce to really sell that effect and make it more authentic. And that would just be by adding real paper textures. And you can find paper textures on stock websites like Pexels or any other stock websites that you have access to. And I already have some here in my media pool, and I'm just gonna use this one right here. I'm just gonna put that on my timeline, just gonna cut it here. Then I'm gonna delete the rest, and I'm gonna use that one and bring that in. Again, cut that to size, and I'm gonna use another one. Let's use this one, for example. I'm gonna cut that to size. And then first of all, I wanna increase the first and the last two by 2 frames so we can fade them in nicely. Same goes for the ending one. I'm gonna fade that out for roughly around 2 frames. But now, if you can see, the papers are not filling the entire screen. So below your viewer, you got this icon right here. Just activate that, which is the transform tool. You can activate that by using the drop-down menu, just selecting it. Now you wanna grab the left and right handles and just drag it to size so it fits the entire screen. I'm gonna repeat that process with the other two. Just gonna drag that over. But right now, all we see are the paper textures. And in order to fix that, we have to change the composite mode. And because it's white that we wanna get rid of, we have to use the composite mode multiply. In order to do that, select the paper texture, come to the inspector in top right corner, and under composite, select the composite mode multiply. Do that for each of the 3 paper textures. I'm gonna use multiply on this one. And on this one, just search for multiply. So now this is coming together really nicely. First of all, let me deactivate the transform tool and play that back. But there's one little thing that's missing, and that would just be a paper crumpling sound effect. And you can find them on freesound.org. I personally use Artlist for that. So if you're interested in trying out Artlist, there's a link in the description where you can get 2 free months. Otherwise, you know where you can get your sound effects from. So I'm gonna make that a little bit smaller. I'm gonna close down my inspector and the effects and media pool so we have a lot more space and can see what's going on. Now I'm gonna shrink that in. I'm gonna fade it in, close the end down, and I'm gonna fade it out like so. And right now that's the perfect paper rip transition effect. And that's it. It's as easy as that to create that cool and unique paper rip transition or effect. And if you're interested in that topic, check out this video right here for more music video related effects. Otherwise, thank you for watching, and I'm gonna see you next week. Bye.